I'm sick of fake people. Please get out my way. Smile in your face, but still talk about you behind your back.
You can't get enough, and you don't know why. Cause you ain't never had a vibe like mine. Whoa. I know what you want, I know what you need.
Good morning, y'all. I'm sorry. I tried to sleep cute tonight. Well, last night. Let me get up. I have to be the pre-op in an hour. Brush my teeth. Oh. I'll be back, y'all.
What's up, you guys? It's your cousin Crystal coming to you with another video. This is going to be pre-op part 2. Trying to get ready. I'm literally probably 17 minutes from Vixen. Right when I put on my clothes, that's when I'm going to order the Lyft, because I've been checking it and it says like they're 3 minutes away, like from this area. So yeah, so I'll be taking y'all along with me.
So who was your doctor? Dr. Cannon. Oh, you were Dr. Cannon? You already had surgery? No, because you sitting on your stuff. Oh. You excited? I'm excited for you too. So look, we don't see Dr. Cannon until the day of surgery, huh? Oh. What you getting done? Oh, okay. I wanted to do the chin too, but I know, I was like, it's gonna be a waste of money. But the lady told me $500. I can lose it. Yeah. You already bought your fire and stuff, or you gonna get it today?
I got
it
already.
Oh. Uh-huh. Oh, your surgery today. You came yesterday. Oh, let me give you a hug. Oh, you here by yourself?
Yeah, I have a. So yeah.
pretty
fun. Yeah. Oh, you going to a recovery house?
Yeah, that's where I came from. She drove my driver.
Oh.
You in right here.
Yeah.
We all we
needed
all the same.
It's all that's what I asked. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But I seen when I was on the elevator, the girl pressed 7. She said she's going to get massages.
No. Over here, your massage
show. Oh, she messes with somebody else.
Different.
Yeah, because I said, who your doctor? She said, Dr. Trish. I ain't never heard of Dr. Trish. Oh.
Yeah.
What? Why she ain't gave me my paperwork yet? That's the question.
They want to go get you
out. Look, all I gotta do is ask her, baby. She the administrator, baby. She know everything. How you know all this?
I'm from Miami, girl.
Oh.
It's her place right here.
Dang. What you getting done?
Oh.
That's what I had last year. I had the hernia repair, muscle repair. No, I went to 305. I had to get that first before I could. Wait a minute. Oh, you can. Dr. Simmons, he not good. He not a goat like Dr. Cannon when it comes to. Huh? No. I'm okay, so let me explain. Let me explain. I got a whole. Girl, no, ma'am.
I got a friend. He's there now, going back.
No. He not like how he used to be. No. No, I'm not getting no infection. My friend got an infection. So wait, did you get your money? Did you get your money back? Your deposit?
No,
you
didn't get.
No, listen. Yeah, that's what I'm trying to do right now. So I paid. Yes. They connected. What?
Oh, that's fine.
Yeah. Yeah, my surgery tomorrow to answer your question.
Mine is
too. Okay, so back to you. I originally had paid a deposit to Dr. Williams. And after I just started praying about it and everything, I started seeing a lot of stuff in the groups. So I got out the groups.
I just want to see nothing I like.
Why don't y'all stay out the
group? No, I'm out the groups. I'm out the groups.
It would drain.
Yeah, I'm out the groups right now. But a close friend of mine went to Dr. Williams. And she had got a bad, bad infection. And then her friend had went, like, 2 weeks after her, and she had got a bad infection.
Why? Just
yeah, and then he wanted me to lose like 30 pounds here and all that.
And
my BMI was good. So anyway, so back to you. So I got a whole blog on it too, girl. It's a long. Oh my God, it's a journey. So originally, I had a hernia. I didn't even know I had a damn hernia. I had to get a hernia repair, a muscle repair, and the tummy tuck. I originally signed up with Dr. Williams to do the lipo BBL 360, but he was like, no, I can't touch you until I get that hernia fixed. So I was like, damn. And then he was like, you need to lose 20, 30 pounds anyway. So I'm like, damn. So I ended up booking Dr. Simmons. Dr. Simmons did my tummy tuck, my hernia repair, and everything. So I make a year post-op in July. So, I mean, you're going to be fine. Only thing that's going to hurt is the muscle repair. It's not the tummy tuck. I done had 2 C-sections and everything. Okay, so with Dr. Simmons, my body had rejected, like, the end of it, like, where the,
How long did you do
the surgery? The, yeah, on the side. It had reopened up. So I had a private nurse, but it was, like, by 2 inches. It had reopened. Yeah, it had closed back up.
She ain't no business doing stuff that she ain't telling y'all what she did. That's why it opened up.
Yeah.
What you
was
doing?
Who?
You.
Oh no, my body rejected it. Oh, the stitches.
Oh,
yeah. I didn't get no infection or anything, luckily, but it had opened up. And so my private nurse came and she put this stuff on it, and it started healing up like within 7 days or whatever. It started closing up or whatever, because I wasn't sitting in the water. Don't sit in the water if you're allergic to that plaque, to that tape that they gonna put on there on your navel. Be careful with that too, because it burns your skin. The surgical tape. Your blood pressure high? Are you having an anxiety attack? Are you overwhelmed? Yeah, you don't have blood pressure issues. Just calm down. Yeah, you got to relax. Yeah, because that's what happened to my auntie. She got to relax. I'm from Houston.
It's lit up down here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Where's my paperwork? That's the question. Girl, why I got a virtual interview at 11:30? Oh, my God. Girl, I'm going to go with somebody else. I don't know. Huh? Oh, no.
From her hometown.
Yeah. I'm going to just tell them we're going to have to, you know, speed it up. I don't know. My dentist's office called me in early. They need me. That's how I look at it. No, I'm going to tell them that my dentist called me in early. All right, getting ready to do paperwork. So let's get this started.
So let me go together again.
So you guys, when you do pre-op, they come in the restroom with you and watch you pee and test your urine. I thought they do that the day of surgery. I guess you're trying to check pregnancy.
Yeah.
Oh, no babies. The third time is the charm. Third time is the charm. Dressy.
It's not working too.
Not working?
No.
Maybe test no good. I thought I heard Dr. Cannon. I thought Dr. Cannon.
Hello. Anita.
Hola. Ya. Listo.
Okay.
Do he do that after surgery? So it's a Lovenox.
It's when you get you after surgery.
And that's $100? Okay. And then you say I have to do the COVID test.
It's 300. Faha COVID test, and that is 300.
Faha COVID test. Yeah. So that's good. So if my 250 can transfer, then I pay the difference. Mm-hmm.
I think so you can do that. I don't know about the money, okay?
That's fine.
Okay, I can tell you that yes, you can do it.
Yeah. Oh, so beautiful. Do I do COVID test with you?
No.
Oh, okay.
You need them first. I take you where you're going to do it.
Oh, okay. I'm glad you let me pee. Oh, my God. Oh.
No worry.
Ooh, thought I was going to have to wait. I had to get that out of me. I've been holding. I drank some apple juice.
Where you from?
Houston.
Houston.
Uh-huh. Houston, Texas. Yeah. You from Miami?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No.
My friend is staying, but he lives here. Your parents pick you up? Go pick you up.
180.
And? Got to do my COVID. Oh, you doing the finger?
No. Your nose.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh,
it
hurts.
Oh, yes, it hurts. Yeah. Okay, you go real fast.
I don't go fast. Oh. I go gentle.
Okay.
I promise
you. Okay.
Yeah,
I'm too high. Gotta do the nasal.
You must be coming from Chicago. From
Houston.
Houston.
Yes.
I know all of you girls coming to about the COVID, like, yeah, I'm going to hurt.
Okay.
Look at me. This is how far I go. Relax.
Oh. Now we go in pain?
Okay.
Hey, you guys, so I'm just waiting to pay. I already did all my paperwork, signed in, did pregnancy test, did the COVID test. It was pretty fast. I've only been here like an hour, and all I gotta do is pay, and that's on that. Once I get back to the room, then I'll get into details of some stuff that I found out once I got here. So I'll see you guys in a little bit. Sleeping. I was in and out. I wasn't playing no games. At pre-op, I did all my paperwork, urine test, drug test. Oh, Lord, paid for everything. Y'all, it was too funny. It was a lady up there. She was in there arguing with them people. Because they canceled her surgery. They said that they found Molly in her system, handlebars, and X pills. And she was in there arguing with them, saying somebody must have put some in her drink. She went out last night. She said, ain't no way.
Smoke weed.
I don't even do drugs. Y'all. I was like, oh, wow. I say, my hemoglobin was low a month ago and I had to get rescheduled. So you think I can make them? No. I was like, they gonna give your money back, girl. Baby, when I tell you, God be right on time. He be right on time. Y'all, I had an 11 o'clock virtual second interview for Texas Children.
Baby.
They called me right on time. I got back to my hotel room 40 minutes early. I got on that MS Team virtual app, whatever. I don't know. And that the Texas Children recruiter will be contacting everyone we decide to go ahead and push forward with. But I know she liked me. We was laughing. We was vibing. We got personal. I got this. Oh my God, this lady asked me so many questions. I guess because I haven't been interviewed for a corporate America job in like forever. I'm not on the clinical side, I'm being on the corporate side. So I was just like, oh my God, I was thinking and thinking, but I think baby.
Oh my God. So I had requested for an early surgery appointment. God is good. I just got this. Fresh hands. Oh, yes, doctor. I gotta be at the surgery center at 5 a.m. Oh, fresh hands.
What's up, you guys? I'm back. Let me close out this video. So, basically, I'm back at the hotel room. I'm about to take a shower. Then I'm going to take probably like a little 2-hour nap. Then get up and eat my grilled chicken salad. But anyways, let me go ahead and give y'all the breakdown of everything. What to be prepared for pre-op at Vinxen. Okay. Ooh, I'm trying not to. Let me just do a quick look, you know, because, you know, I get to talking. But I want to make sure y'all know everything before you come to Vinxen, okay? Because it's going to fill you in. Okay, let's go. And I got some receipts. So, first off, when you first get there, it's cold as hell. It's cold. I'm gonna let you know that now. Bring a jacket or a robe or something, a blanket. It's cold. You only feel the warmth once you get back there and do your COVID test.
I gotta lay down. I'm so tired. I'm sorry, y'all. Okay, so. Oh, my God. Y'all, I'm so tired. Like, filling out all that paperwork, being up there early in the morning, like, trying to beat the rush. I am so glad. Like, they'll call y'all and they'll verify, like, what time you want to be at, what time you want to be or what time you want to come to pre-op. And some people probably say 9, 10, 11, because I think they do it all the way to, like, 1 o'clock or something. I don't know. But anyways, long story short, I told her 8 o'clock. I got there at 8 o'clock. Well, probably like 10 minutes after because my Uber got lost. But anyways, I got there at 8 o'clock, 8:15-ish, whatever. And it was like probably 2 to 3 women. Yeah, probably like 2 to 3 women in the already in there doing paperwork. Well, no. It was 2 doing paperwork and it was 2 my earpiece, y'all. I bet y'all like, what's she doing? Make sure it don't come out. So it was 2 people in there doing paperwork, sitting down doing their paperwork. And then it was 1 girl. She had just came from in the back. She was changed, like she was getting ready to have surgery. But they canceled her due to, they said her blood pressure or something was high because I think she was, everybody was saying she was overwhelmed. Like her anxiety was flaring up. She was too excited. And she said, I don't even take blood pressure medicine. What they mean? My heart rate, my blood pressure up. I was like, oh, Lord. So she got rescheduled for tomorrow. I think she got to come back tomorrow evening for Dr. Cannon. Okay, so anyway, so when you get there, it's cold. Try to get there as early as possible because by the time I came from out the back, and I came from out the back around 10 o'clock, I was roughly there probably an hour 30 hour 40 minutes due to the fact that one of the ladies that's supposed to take the payments, she pregnant and she wasn't there today. She had a doctor's appointment. So it was only left on 1 person versus 2. But yeah, I like how they moved though. They moved pretty fast, I'm not gonna lie, versus all the plastic centers I've ever witnessed or been to for even a consultation or anything. Yeah, they moved pretty fast. Okay. Yeah, I'm so sorry. But I'm telling y'all, my videos, I'm telling you, they just be real and raw. Like, I'm tired, okay? So, when you get there, it's cold. You go sign in at the desk. You go sign in at the desk. Once you sign in at the desk, sign your name in. The lady at the desk, if somebody's at the desk, she gonna, while you standing up there, she gonna say, can I see your ID? You're going to give her your ID. If you pay using whatever debit card or whatever, she's going to ask to see it. So, and she's going to ask to make a copy of it. So make sure y'all bring the card that y'all use to either make y'all payments or that y'all use to pay your deposit, because they want to see proof of it. I think they have another way that you can do it if you no longer have that bank account, or you no longer have that card in your possession, or if somebody else made the payment for you. I think you have to get some type of form notarized or a bank statement or something. I don't know. But it's ways around it, okay? So, because I know some people pay their deposits from a year in advance, and some of them probably don't have that card no more. So, anyway, so they're going to want to see that. After they see that, they're going to tell you, go have a seat. Now, when you go have a seat, let me tell y'all right now, when you go have a seat, everybody in the lobby, they're talking. Everybody trying to know who doctor you going to, what you getting done, how much did you get in on a special. And it's okay to talk to the other people. But let me tell y'all something. While y'all talking to them other people, if they up there calling your name and you miss your name being called, because they're not out there like screaming. They talk very softly to me. They up there calling your name and you over there talking and you don't hear your name, they're going to skip over you. So the lady kept coming out and she was calling names, and I'm like, why she ain't calling my name yet? Girl, so I went up there. It's not that I missed them calling my name. They never had called my name. But the whole time they be up there talking too. Like, they get easily distracted too, because you have to realize people are popping up there for consultations. People coming up there signing in and asking additional questions. People coming up there for surgery and needing to buy a faja or something like that. So, especially if it's only one person up there. So, anyways, you want to be alert and paying attention so you can get in and out, okay? So sign in, sit down, make sure you sit close to the front so you can see what they got going on. If you feel like you've been sitting too long, get up and say something. You don't got to be rude about it. Just get up and say something. I went up there after sitting down for like 20 minutes only because I had a brief question. I had a question about my $250 deposit that I paid Dr. Williams at 305. Could that be transferred to Vixen, to Dr. Cannon? Towards my balance or whatever. I already know y'all not gonna give me a refund, so can it be transferred towards my balance that I have with him, with Dr. Cannon, or can I use it towards a garment? You still winning because the garments are $150 and you got $250. So neither here or there. I sat down. I went up there, like I said, to ask them brief questions. While I was up there, I seen my folder, because what they're going to do is after you sign in, it's another lady that goes and puts your chart together, or she bring your chart or whatever from the back. And she start highlighting stuff or whatever for you to go fill out. So while I'm talking to her, I see like two or three charts. They just stacked up because, you know, it's thick. Oh, Lord, it's so thick. So I see like two or three charts stacked up, but mine on the top, I see my name big in red letters on the folder. So I'm like, I say, ma'am, is that my chart? It say my name on it, my full name. She say, oh, tell me your name again. And I'm saying in my head, I just told you that's my name. But then I just told her my name. And then she was like, oh, okay. So she gave me my chart. She say that in regards to the $250, she going to get with the manager or whatever. And then once I get to the back to get ready to pay, they'll discuss it or call over there and see if it's something they can do about it in billing. So I was like, okay, cool. So I'm like, oh, yeah, I got my chart. So let me go ahead and start filling this shit out. So I started filling it out, right? I don't know what happened to the other two girls that was already in there before me that was filling out their paperwork. All I know is the lady called me like after 5 or 10 minutes after me starting on my chart. She called me. And I want to say, oh, you know what? That's what it was. The other two girls, they was with Triggs. So I guess everybody have their own Triggs and Cannon have their own like assistance or whatever. And I guess I was the first Cannon doll to get there this morning. So his nice administrator assistant, she came and got me, and I was like, I'm not finished with my she was like, don't worry, you can do it in the office. I started walking faster. I said, oh yeah, no problem, my love, No problem. So then, y'all know I'm goofy. So then, cousin, I'm telling this lady I gotta pee. I had drunk apple juice and water this morning, and I'm like, ma'am, I have to pee. I've been holding my pee for y'all because I know y'all gonna want to check my urine. Can I pee? So she's like, yeah, okay, so let's go do that first. So we go to her office, get the cup and all that or whatever. So I'm like, where's the restroom? So she pointed straight ahead. So I'm going to the restroom. I'm trying to close the door. Girl, why the door pushing back open? I'm like, what? I said, you gotta use it? Like, what the hell, girl? She said, oh no, I just need to watch you. I'm like, oh Lord, here we go with this shit. So girl, be prepared at pre-op. They're gonna come in there and watch you pee, okay? I thought they do that the day of surgery, but who is this texting me? I'll get back to them. But the day of, I think I'm gonna have to do that again because they want to test, make sure you ain't pregnant, make sure you ain't been drinking, make sure you ain't been smoking or did no drugs overnight. So anyways, long story short, the lady came in there. She watched me pee. Girl, I filled up that thing almost over the rim. I was like, I'm sorry. She said, no, the more the better. I said, oh, okay, well, here you go, my love. So then, girl, she took my pee. She started testing it. Oh, God. As you see in the video, girl, she did like 5 rounds. I don't know if that was an old pack of pregnancy stack or what. I say you can keep retesting it until we get some results, because it wasn't coming up as nothing. I think them was the cheap ones. I don't know, but even when I was pregnant, the cheap ones was good. Look, I don't know, but once she got to the fourth or the fifth one, it finally started showing up. So she just used both of them. So we done with the pregnancy part. After the pregnancy part, we goes to her office. We continue filling out the paperwork. Once I got finished filling out my paperwork, she began to start filling out her portion of the paperwork. After that, she did my height, my weight, my BMI. My BMI ended up being a 30 point something. I already put it in the video. Y'all seen it. And after that, after my BMI and all that, she goes to explain, so your balance is 52-50. I'm like, yes. Then she was like, so your COVID test to take that is through your nose, the nasal, is going to be $50. I was like, I already did a COVID test. She was like, oh, do you have the results? Girl, so they didn't tell me that they needed a COVID test within 7 days. Like, they didn't tell me that they need a COVID, somebody keep calling me. They didn't tell me that they need a COVID test within 7 days, right? So I had to end up paying $50. I could have got that done free in Texas at Walgreens drive-thru for free. I just told, I said, okay, ma'am, just add it on now. $50, okay, just add that on now. And they give you instant results. Mine was negative. Okay, after that, so bam, we checked in. I like to go back so I can make sure I covered everything. So, because I don't be seeing this a lot on YouTube videos. I be like, did she skip something? And I want to make sure I ain't skip nothing. So, bam, we get there. It's cold. We sign in. You get your chart. Pay attention. Watch. They calling your name. If they ain't calling your name in 30 minutes, go up there and see what's going on nicely. Because when I tell y'all I was so nice to them people, that could have been a reason why she called me to the back real fast too, because I was real nice. Because most people, you know, some of them girls be coming up there being ghetto, rude, loud, da 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 da. Because I've witnessed it. Like, why y'all be talking to them people like that? So I went up there. I was nice. I was smiling to everybody. I came in, said good morning, positive vibes across the board. Okay. And then surgery is tomorrow, so I want to be on an utmost positive, like, high volume, peaceful vibe. Like, I don't got time for all that. So, yeah. So, then you go do your pee test. Then you go finish your paperwork. Then you do your weight, your height. She gonna give you a paper. It's gonna be, oh yeah, I need to read over that paper. It's a paper she gave me for me to read so I can know how to take care of myself for post-operative and what to expect and all that. But I swear, I thought she already sent that in an email, but it's a paper too. And then she gonna give you a copy of your BMI and all that or whatever. So she told me my BMI was perfect. After that, I went and did the COVID. She gonna do the swab of the nose. It's gonna take not even 5 minutes. And she gave you instant results. Mine was negative. After that, then you go to the payment room. So go to the payment room. I had to pay $52.50. On top of that, I had to pay another $50. Hold on, because you know I got these receipts. Oh, this video already. Oh my God, this is gonna be a long video. But this is what y'all want. Y'all, we want informative, so let me be informed. So yeah, girl, I had to pay $50, not for to show y'all, for the COVID-19 test, instant results. Then for your garment, it's $150. I had to pay that because you're going to wake up in your faja. For the now, they told me this today. Thank God I had extra money, okay? I had to pay an additional $100 for Love Knox 1 test. So basically, they say that's a shot that you get after you come out of recovery after surgery. They give you that shot. It's a blood thinner shot, so you won't be losing a lot of blood because Dr. Cannon don't offer blood savers anymore. I mean, I'm talking about blood savers, same thing, but cell savers anymore. So the shot, the Love Knox shot, is $100. I heard a bit of confusion about this in the lobby when they was talking about it, saying something about like their insurance will cover it or something like that. I don't know. It maybe they can give you a prescription for it, but how they was explaining it's like straight off the table, you need to have this shot. And it's $100 and they the one administer it to you. So yeah, that total was $300 here. $300, and you see surgical garment body, $150, COVID-19, $50, Lovenox shot, $100. On top of that, I paid $52.50 remaining balance, and I paid a deposit of $250. So roughly, that's $5,500. 55, 56, 57, 58. So roughly for this procedure, I paid $5,800. That's for my procedure, lipo, 360 BBL, for my shot, my garment, and my COVID test. $5,800. My recovery house is $1,200. I'm getting 2 massages while I'm here. One of them is $120, and then the other one is $65 because I'm doing an in-house one too. I have somebody coming to me that's mobile, and then I'm doing one with the in-house people. That's because I didn't know that she offered that, so I'm gonna get one Sunday before I leave. And then what else? Then I think that's it. So yeah, be prepared. I always bring extra money. If you want more than one garment, you most definitely can. I don't know what color for her I'm gonna wake up in, black or beige. I don't care as long as it's doing what it's supposed to be doing. Then once I get back home, I have a faja place at home that I'm gonna go ahead and buy a faja from. But yeah, that's a wrap for this video. I did get the text message. Oh, if you want an early appointment, FYI, if you want an early appointment at Vixen, when you go back there and you make your payment, let her know that you want an early appointment. Those doctors begin there at 4 a.m. So let them know that you want an early appointment, and they will write it on your chart. Because some people don't be caring. Some people come in at 10, 11, or 12, or 1. Now, I don't want you touching me right before it's your lunchtime, because you're trying to hurry up so you can go eat steak and shakes. I don't got time for that. I don't want to come right after you come back from lunch because you good and full and you being lazy and you want to hurry up and rush so you can go sit down and take a break. No, thank you. I want to come there early, bright in the morning, fresh hands. You done already had a cup of coffee and you ready to go. So I just got a text message saying that my procedure is in the morning at 5:30 a.m. So I'm just going to take me a shower. I'm just going to eat me a grilled chicken salad. I cannot eat after 11 or 12. I'm not going to eat after 10. To be on the safe side, I'm just going to stay hydrated, drink some water all the way to 11 p.m. I'm going to drink a gallon of water by the end of this night. I'm going to bathe in my disinfectant soap tonight and in the morning. So actually, I'm going to get up at 3:30 a.m. I already pre-scheduled my lift. My lift supposed to be here at 4:20. It's 30 minutes from here, so I should get there right at like 4:50. And my surgery is at 5:30. So, yeah, I'm going to get there like 30, 45 minutes early. So, yeah, that's that. So, I'm going to go ahead and end this vlog of part 2 pre-op. Tomorrow is surgery day. I'm going to vlog a little bit in the morning on my way going there. And probably while I'm in the waiting area, waiting to get drawn up. Then after that, y'all already know I can't vlog until after I wake up at the recovery house. Once I get to walking around and feeling a little bit better, probably later on that day, then I'll do a tour at my recovery house. So, yeah, that'll be that. But make sure y'all check out that last video that I uploaded, Packing With Me. I had a lot of intel information on that video, as well as about, you know, what to bring, what, you know, blah, blah. Other than that, I need to call United so I can add wheelchair on my way going home. I got my body pillow. I didn't bring a BBL pillow for my flight going back home. I'm just ready to get home, get in my bed so I can start healing. I got 2 mobile massages that's going to be coming to my house. So yeah, thank you guys for following this journey so far. It's still going on, so it's still trending. I got most stuff coming up. Y'all supposed to be like, what the hell? Yeah, that's what mama said the other day. She was like, what else you getting done? I said, girl, stay tuned. But let me enjoy this BBL journey. You know, it's been a long journey. I'm so glad I finally made it. I was able to maintain and continue saving money because it was tempting. Oh, girl, you know how many times I was looking at them Dior slides and them Louis earrings and, yeah. But anyways, y'all stay blessed. I will see y'all on the flat side. And like I said, I'll vlog a little bit in the morning so y'all can see. I'm just ready to go shower so I clean this makeup off. But, yeah, y'all stay blessed. It's your cousin Crystal, and I'm out.
Give me my theme music.